a bunch of them a struggle before, but we're actually not in the motherlode, Jack. You have debated us. We are in the Shrine of the Storm right now, and now immediately running down the stairs, as we see teams typically do, mass pull coming in here, and they will try to group up and snap all of these casters together on top of these Brazier. Excellent done here by Method EU. Bloodlust has been popped here from both sides. Exactly mirror strategy starting out for both.
Yeah, we've actually seen this exact same thing from Team D before and from 40K, and both those teams pulled this strategy off perfectly. Now we see Method EU and Method NA both tanks just kiting backwards. We see Now and Nerf just going back up the stairs to make sure the casters are outranging them, so they have to follow them so they don't actually keep casting all the time, because these water blasts just do so much damage, and at some point you run out of interrupts.
You're going to run out of interrupts, but you can see both tanks, what they do is they dip in bit by bit once in a while. By doing so, they actually get the mobs to recast again, and before that water blast cast finishes, they back off, and the mob cancels its cast because their current target is out of range. A lot of bursting damage coming in here for Method EU. No problem for Xaelia, though. Group nice and healthy, back above 70%. Method NA already done here as they mass stealth yet again downwards, getting ready. Actually, I thought they were going to go to the boss, but they're grabbing a couple more. They're actually in combat with a critter on the side. Okay, so they decide to off a critter and make sure that doesn't bother them later. Method EU looking like they're trying to proc their first reaping pull upstairs here with the casters, Nagura.
Yeah, interesting strategy here for Method EU. They're actually doing two different kind of pulls here. They did not get 15% from the first pull like Method NA did. They only got 13, and now they're doing a second pull where they don't not only pull the spiritualist from the top, but they also pull some more trash from the bottom. Now, what this will make happen for them is later on they can do some trash, or they can skip some trash that Method NA has to play later on. So we'll see how the strategy turns out for Method EU later on, but Method NA already proc 20% reaping wave. They did shed them out as much as possible off, and the rest of the mobs are getting dragged on top of this first boss.
Here. Yoda dipping to 5% here for Method NA as they get started with that first reaping wave on Akusir, arguably the best designed dungeon boss in the entirety of the BFA dungeons. Akusir now down to 90% as Method EU rushes down into action and gets ready to shadow meld off, I believe, the entirety of the reaping wave as well. So they don't want to deal with that on top of the boss, but Method NA looking really strong here already.
Yeah, so Method EU did get the Reaping Wave on top, and then they walked down, and now they have this additional trash that Method NA already killed or is killing right now while they're fighting the first boss, and now Method EU will put it on top of the boss as well. Now, both of those teams used to let us earlier, so this kind of pull where they pulled the trash on top of the boss is very dangerous, and we've seen 40K struggle to this exact same thing earlier, where we saw the tank go down, and then the battle rest came back up, but some a damage dealer died while this whole thing was happening, so definitely a very difficult cool pull because there's just so many casters, so much damage on the tank, and then of course it's 45 too, so if there's any cast going through, it's just so much damage.
This is super duper scary indeed for both sides. I mean, even those Mending Rapids getting off, I mean, you're just in a huge amount of trouble. Everything just gets healed up immensely, so every single kick has to be absolutely on point, every defensive play for not only the tanks but the melee included as well. Method EU down to 73% on Akusir here as Method NA has already transitioned into the transition phase itself, where the three Aqua Links have split into the equilateral triangle across the circular platform, making sure that they cast the exact same abilities as the boss. Surging Rush, Surge Rush is of course the most dangerous ability. Team does very well to avoid it and not get knocked off the platform Nagura style here.
Wow, I've never fallen off this platform before in my life. So Method and I actually are in the second phase already. Actually, no, they have to kill the last Aqua Link to get into the second phase, while Method EU is still in the first phase. So Method EU slightly behind when it comes to boss HP, but if you look at the trash percentage, they are ahead in trash, and they also still have more apprentices that they're fighting currently. So once those will go down, they will be quite significantly ahead in trash percentage. So that's the difference in boss HP that you can see between those two teams here.
Yeah, certainly Method NA will have to make up some of this percentage elsewhere, but they as well have some initiatives that they've downed here, getting that 30%, and Akusir here now down in the single target, single digits of percent, 8% left to go there. Method EU chewing through the rest of these Aqualings, making sure to dodge the surging rush, and a most fortunate rush there. They actually have them within cleave range, the remaining two of each other, so nice efficiency there for Method EU, and a bit of luck on their side as well, as Method NA has finished the boss first, understandably so, because they have done a bit less of the trash and are skipping past the Heldis, of course, the mini boss.
Yeah, so Method NA, since they only have 29% trash at this point, they will have to do all of the trash here that is available to them in this area before the mini boss. And once they kill all of this pool off that they've have gathered here, then they will proc their 40% reaping wave and they can do the Shadow Meld skip. But we actually saw them all drop very low because of the bursting. So So you definitely want to be very careful when it comes to bursting, especially in Shrine, because Shrine has a lot of low HP mobs that apply bursting to you. So you want to be careful to not roll the bursting and not make the job of the healer very difficult.
Yeah, it's going to be quite scary as well before the second boss, the council boss, where there's about 20 of those initiates too. So they're going to have to very well control the bursting there. Now, Volcanic in this dungeon, really a non-factor, but you can get clipped by it if you're not paying attention or in a tight camera spot like this hallway. Excellent view from the observers here from the top of the hallway, so we can see all of the action and understand exactly how the players are moving and where they are moving to. Method EU about to proc their second Reaping Wave in just a moment. I expect by doing so, they will actually run and use it to skip the bridge as well and do the coveted but very dangerous skip. Quite the chokehold and bottleneck on some team strategies. Here they go. Now runs in and pulls the elemental to the side. Defensive Ring of Peace goes down to make sure that the mobs on either side cannot get in. Now immediately leaps in. Everybody shadow melds off. A perfect skip from the team right now as they hide in the corner.
Yeah, so Method EU actually caught up quite a bit here because they didn't have to do as much trash on this pull as Method NA because they just had more percentage from the pulls earlier. So Method EU were faster with the 40% Reaping Wave proc. They walked through, they pulled the whole area here with all the apprentices. And now this is actually a very difficult pull because there's lots of cast that needs to be interrupted. There's lots of tank damage, as you can see now, drop very low here. And then there's also those tornadoes that you can see spawn that do so much damage if you get hit by them.
Yeah, the Tempests are certainly very dangerous and you have a really limited amount of kicks here. You have four kicks across the group. Of course, Zele can't contribute to that. He's already busy healing. You have some form of crowd control, of course. Shockwaves, leg sweeps. You see one go down on Method EU side right there as they finish up the rest of the trash, well controlling their bursting stacks here. A six stack, but should be no problem for Zele to heal up the rest of that as they prepare to pull this mass amount of initiates, probably bit by bit, but they don't actually. They have debated me, and they're indeed mass stealthing right up to Galecaller Faye and, of course, Brother Ironhull.
Yeah, this is exactly what I've been talking about earlier when we saw the other Shrine being played by 40k and TMD, that this is what Method EU does whenever there's a bursting affix, is they just use their Shroud, get just Shroud past initiates, because the initiates, yeah, they give count and they have low HP, but when it's bursting, you can't pull them all and kill them at the same time. You have to kill them one by one, or you have to stop DPS and wait until the bursting disappeared and then keep going. So it's just very inefficient to pull them, so Method EU just chooses to have the Shroud go past them and just pull something else later on, and I really like the strategy out of both of those teams here.
Yeah, completely mirrored play here from both sides, from both EU and NA counterpart alike, pulling eight of those initiates on top of the boss here. Brother Ironhull 77% and Galecaller Faye 40% for Method EU. They're trying as best as they can to constantly stay in the swiftness rune from Galecaller Faye that increases movement speed but haste as well by 25% increase, which just gives a tremendous DPS boost, as you can see, on purpose letting some of these slicing blasts go through so that they don't spawn too many tornadoes on the platform. Once Galecaller Faye, we do know, is buffed and you interrupt her with that buff up, she will spawn tornadoes around the platform. So it should be no problem for them. They can dip into the rune from Brother Ironhull and get rid of that debuff.
Yeah, so if you, the only difference between those two teams right now is the 1% trash difference. Method NA 54% while Method EU is on 55. So this might not look like a lot of difference, but it might mean a lot later, because if you have to pull a whole extra pack or you have to do one extra mob, it's going to cost you a lot of time. It depends what Method NA has to pull to make up for this missing percentage here. But both of those teams, once Galecaller Faye is dead, like it is soon for both teams, then they can pull one extra Enforcer on top, which we've seen from other teams before, where the healer just runs off, pulls the Patrolling Enforcer, and just kills it with Brother Ironhull, because he doesn't really do anything anymore.
We actually see some apprentices pulled here from Method NA as well, the ones that patrol up the bridge, and they're also pulling some initiates extra on top of it, so that should answer your question, Nagura, of where they're getting the extra trash percent. Scary indeed, but once Brother Ironhull is the only one alive, the boss really isn't too dangerous.
Bursting.
They just have to be careful with the bursting. There should be a 4-stack immediately from the initiates, which should fall off, and then easily they can deal the rest of the pull here.
You're at 16!
I was talking about Method NA on the side, but Method EU deals well with their stacks and downs the rest of the initiates as well. 57% on the board for Method EU. Here comes the rest of the pull for Method NA right now. Nerfclap taking a fair bit of damage, and they're going to deal with their round of big bursting.
Okay, so once they get the bursting, they need to make it into the zone very quickly. As you can see, Nerf just leaping into there, because without this zone, they're definitely going to die if they don't have an immunity. So anyone who's not a rogue will die to those stacks. So very well done by both those teams, making use of the boss mechanic. Yoda actually proccing his cheat death here, but thankfully he is a rogue and he did not die. Nerf Club also dropping very low. They have to be careful here once they finish off this last this boss fight here. But they've managed to survive, everyone. Now, Method EU proc to 60% Reaping, and Method NA still has to deal with this last Enforcer because it got pulled a little bit late.
Yeah, they're doing quite mirror strategies here, but indeed the Enforcer is taking just way too long for Method and A to go down. Finally, it does so. They pop their Swiftness Potions, and they're going to hurry along to the bridge as quickly as possible, shadow melding not only all the trash they pull on the way, but of course the third round of Reaping as well. Nerfclap getting that intimidating shout at the very end there, making sure none of the mobs follow them. There's the shadow meld that we were expecting as they mount up and get ready for the bridge. Pretty substantial pull coming in here for Method EU as well. One Tormented Soul leaked on the side there. Should be no big deal for them as somebody will hopefully get an interrupt on it soon so that they could bring it into the pack and effectively cleave it down. Mental Assaults going off left and right as the group makes sure not to get hit by that 5-second stun frontal.
Yeah, Method EU actually pulled one of the bridge packs on top of the tentacles, and it's just... it was very efficient by them. They just got to 60% right after the boss was dying. So they just mounted up. They did just skip straight away with the Shadow Melt. And we actually have one death on Method and Asa because Yoda just did not have the cheat death available anymore because it procced in the boss fight before. So there's one death. It's actually, I mean, they do have a battle rest to get him back up. But this match is so close between those two teams. So this, the 5 seconds might actually matter.
Yeah, it will matter a lot between them right now. Nerfclap getting a ton of damage and Rip Mines going off, decreasing his max HP by 10% as well. Well, including a huge amount of shadow damage as well. JB taking a huge amount, a huge hit as well. Nerfclap has dipped and lost his trinket. JB goes down and Nerfclap follows suit. They're trying to finish off the rest of the trash without the tank and healer alive, but Shaqib cannot hang on long enough. Yoda goes down. Shaqib has procced his cheat death, and it looks like it's going to be a full team wipe here for Method and A. Absolutely disastrous. They don't have their checkpoint available either, so they will have to start from the beginning of the dungeon and get back up while Method EU has already finished the bridge trash and is going on to the next room, procking the RP on the third boss, Lord Stormsong.
This is such a disaster for Method and A. We've talked about this over and over and over. Shrine is one dungeon where you just cannot make a mistake like that. If you have a team wipe coming in, if you have your healer down and no rest available, then you need to have your whole team released. You have to re-kill all this reaping that you skip, because there's not a single reaping wave that the teams actually kill. They all skip them with Shadow Melt. So all those reaping waves that they Shadow Melt, they have to re-kill them just because this is going to take them so long to come back. Method EU, just all eyes on them at this point. They have 81% trash. They are in Lord Stormsong, so the only thing left between them and winning this first map is going to be the two bosses and the trash percentage that they're going to get in the last boss room.
Yeah, I mean, there's frankly no way Method and A is catching up short of a wipe on Method EU. And even if Method EU wipes after Lord Stormsong, once Lord Stormsong dies, and there's no way they're going to wipe on it, it's a fortified boss right now, it will get the checkpoint at that point, so they're not going to be warped all the way to the beginning of the dungeon and have the issue that Nagura mentioned of needing to deal with all the backlogged trash from the Reaping. Lighty goes down again on Method and A, and this is just absolutely disastrous from them. They're trying to claw back up right now, but aren't able to do so. Azalea actually dips quite low from one of the Rip Mines from Lord Stormsong, but manages to stabilize and dispel himself, getting as much damage in and just letting his healing over time get him back to max HP.
It actually could have been a disaster for Method EU too, because again, if Xellia dies, they cannot rest him. There's no battle rest available to them because Druid, of course, the only class in their composition that can use that battle rest. So Xellia definitely needs to be careful to not go down here. We all know Xellia is one of those players who wants to min-max DPS as much as possible, but of course, if he just stays alive, they're gonna win. And if they, you know, if they don't have any wipes anymore, no matter how fast they are going to win. But that's something they don't know. They don't know that Method and A wiped, right? So they're just gonna play as always. They're not gonna adapt anything. And it's also something they told us, that even when they were playing on online tournaments, when they had the ability to watch other teams play, they wouldn't do so. They would not adjust their strategies depending if they were ahead or behind. They would just always play their strategy no matter what.
Yeah, Method EU is just always playing their own game. They don't care what anybody else is doing. They just want to make sure they're doing it best. They actually jump in the water there a bit too early. Lord Stormsong's water is actually incredibly dangerous, dealing a huge amount of damage. Xaelia, unfortunately, embarrassingly so, getting hit by one of the jellyfish that stuns you for 8 seconds. No immunity will get you out of that. So a bit of time lost there, but fortunately makes up for it by the fact that he has that horribly ugly aquatic form for the druid, and he still gets ahead of the group there too. But what I was mentioning is that the water is actually quite dangerous. You need to wait a few seconds after you kill Lord Stormsong to go in the water, else you will pulse a lot of damage, which just completely unnecessarily procced Fragnance's cheat death there.
Yeah, so no cheat death available for Fragment. We see now actually pulled some of those mobs. I'm not sure if it was intentional because Sahalia actually did use the stealth to make sure he goes faster. But now does have Avago from those eels. And as we talked about this earlier, those eels actually do not proc bursting. So bursting is not going to be a big deal here. They're still fortified though. And the debuff that they apply to the tank, the stacking bleed debuff, does do a lot of damage. So you definitely want to be careful with those eels as well.
Yeah, should be no big eel for them indeed as Method EU rears up and grabs the last boss, Volzith the Whisperer here. Now, we know the common strat here, of course. Just go through the motions really quickly. They will get to the phase transition where they will abuse the healer, the mass healer damage buff, 90% increased damage for the rest of the fight by leaving the boss in the transition state casting as they go and clean up most of the rest of the trash in the room before returning and popping Bloodlust on the boss to finish it in one phase.
Yeah, that's why all of those teams are saving their Bloodlust, right? I think teams just do not have enough damage to pull this damage up without the Bloodlust, or it's just too risky. Because if you do get the second transition phase, if you don't have enough damage, you just lose way too much time. So teams are just saving your Bloodlust, and you can see they are in the transition phase right now. The damage dealers, of course, are in a different realm than the healer and the tank, and you have to deal with different kind of mobs, but it really should not be a problem for those kind of teams. Actually, there we go, Maris actually going down. I think he got hit by a tentacle, because if it was a cast going through, then everyone else would have died too. So probably getting hit by a tentacle. They do have one battle rush to get him back up, though.
Yeah, well, but, you know, we did talk earlier to Mirrors, and he's actually a huge fan of the Ayaya meme, so it makes sense that he would get hit by the tentacles just in his desire to do so. He's certainly just doing it for show and not an accident by any means. Method EU here, 88% on the board, and Method NA is still trying to figure out right now exactly how they're going to get past all of the trash and third Reaping Wave that they skipped earlier. Not all of them are near the bridge yet. JB finally across the bridge, and they are getting ready again with 9 deaths on the board, but Method EU about to finish off the 3 pull of trash right in front of Volzith and getting ready to pop their Bloodlust in just a moment.
Yeah, I think at this point Method NA just has to like focus on the next game really, because there's no way they're going to come back. Even if Method EU wipes at this point, there's no way. Method EU has to wipe multiple times even for Method NA to have a chance at all. And I think since our host and our analyst just got back to the desk, they also saw that the game is about to be over. So maybe they're just like, you know what, guys? Let's focus on the next game. As Method EU is about to down the boss and only have to do 7% trash left to do.
That's actually not true. I told them there was free pizza here, so they came rushing over right now to the disappointment that there is indeed no food at the desk. Volzith the Whisperer, 15% for Method EU right now with 4 seconds left on their Bloodlust. Easily one phaseable, making sure none of those manifestations reach the boss after this. They will just mass pull the remainder of the eels on the side and get their 100%. They waste no time doing so as they parade in on top of the group.
So they actually managed to keep the debuff on Sally. As you can see, the damage debuff is still on Sally there because they did not drop combat. So very well done by Method EU to not finish, to pull the mobs, the eels, while they were still in boss combat, to just keep this extra damage buff on Sally. As you can see, him doing 100k DPS here.
And the cheers come in for Method EU right now with a hugely dominant performance on the first map. Method NA is definitely going to have to regroup to try and take this to a game 3.